Hello and welcome back to another fun video on Ionic. So in this video, we are going to learn about deep links and how we can use deep links in our Ionic applications. So here is a blog post about deep links on blog.ionic.io by Max Lynch. And in this amazing blog post, he explains clearly what are deep links. So basically, deep links are URLs that make it possible to take your user to a very specific point in your application. So for example, you have an e-commerce application and you want the user to be navigated to a particular page in your application with a very particular product displaying. With deep links, you can do that. All your user will have to do is click on a link, and that link will take the user to that very specific point in your application, and that product will be displaying on that particular page. So this is how deep links work, and you might have seen this with a number of popular applications like Instagram, Amazon, and even WhatsApp. So how deep links work is that we have to define a custom URL scheme for our application. As you can see here, we have an example of Instagram. So Instagram has a custom URL scheme defined, which is called Instagram. So all the URLs starting with this protocol will be handled by the Instagram application. Similarly, we can define a custom URL scheme for our own Ionic application, and then all the URLs with that custom URL scheme will be handled by our application. So let's see this in action. So I have created this new Ionic application, which is called Ionic Deep Links. And what I'm going to do is open this application in Visual Studio Code. So the application is now open in Visual Studio Code, and the first thing that we'll have to do is install the required plugins and Ionic Native modules. So let's head over to the Ionic Native website and here find the Deep Links section. On the Deep Links page, you will see that you need to install an Ionic Cordova plugin and also an Ionic Native module for Deep Links. So what I'm going to do is just copy this, and I'm going to come back to Visual Studio Code and open a terminal here, and I'm going to paste in this command. Now this command specifies four different parameters that you need to specify while installing this plugin. The first parameter is the URL scheme, and this is the URL scheme that should be unique throughout all the applications that the user has installed on their device. So it is a better option that you keep your URL scheme such that it is not duplicated by any other application. So for now, what I'm going to do is call my URL scheme mycoolapp. So all my URLs will start with mycoolapp. Then you specify a deep link scheme. I'm going to leave it HTTPS. The third variable is deep link host. This takes in the domain name or the URL to your website. So I'm just going to call it Samarth.com for now. There is no such website. I'm just going to keep it like this so I can later demonstrate how it works. And lastly, the Android path prefix. I'm going to leave it default. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to hit enter. So this will install the plugin. And since I'm working with the latest Ionic CLI, I also need to install CLI plugin Cordova. So I'm just going to input yes here. So this will install the CLI plugin Cordova, and then we'll install Ionic plugin deep links. While it completes, let's go back to Ionic Native website and grab this second command, which is used to install the Ionic Native module for deep links. Come back to Visual Studio Code and now paste in this command. So the Ionic Native module and the Ionic Cordova plugin both are installed. So the first thing that we'll have to do is go to the SRC folder, open the app folder, and go to app.module.ts. Here I'll have to import the deep links plugin. After importing, I'll have to pass it in the providers array. So I'll just do that. Now let's go to the page app.component.ts, because this is the page which is loaded first in our application, and this is the place where I want to handle all the deep links. So I'm just gonna import deep links here as well, and I'm gonna pass it into my constructor. Now we are ready to use deep links. But for now, let's run this application in an emulator and see how the installation of Cordova Deep Links plugin modified how our application behaves. So what I'm going to do is initiate the run command here. So I'm just going to type in Ionic Cordova run Android, and this will add the Android platform as well. So while our application is built and deployed on an Android device, what I'm going to do is open codepen.io and I'm going to create a new codepen. And what I'll do is write some HTML code to generate a link so that our application can be tested for that custom URL scheme that we have just created. And the URL to this anchor tag will start with mycoolapp. Remember, we specified mycoolapp as the URL scheme for our Ionic application. Okay, and after that, I'll specify the name of the domain that I specified while installing that plugin. Okay, so this is our URL which we are going to use to test our Ionic application's deep link functionality. I'm going to save this codepen, and this gives me a unique URL that I can now access on my Android device. Okay, so let's leave this open for now and let's head over to our emulator. So the application has launched now, everything is as usual, nothing special has happened. And now what we are going to do is close this application and I'll open the web browser on my Android device and I'll open this CodePen page in my emulator. So I'll just type in the URL and I'll hit enter. Okay, so you can see that this opens the same exact page in my browser. And if I click on this link that I have created right here, this should launch my application because the URL scheme specifies mycoolapp and this phone right here knows that all the URLs starting with mycoolapp are to be handled by our Ionic application. So let's try and click on this link. And you can see that our Ionic application launches up. Okay, so this way we can create custom URLs. These URLs will launch our application. But how can we send specific data to our application with the help of these links, and how can we receive that data in our application so as to perform some navigation or manipulation in our application? So let's check that out. So let's go back to our Ionic application, and inside my platform.ready function right here, so I'm just going to type in this .deeplinks.route, and this route function takes in some parameters that I'm going to explain in just a moment. For now, what I'm going to do is just pass in a blank JSON object here. Okay, and this returns us an observable so I can subscribe to that. And the first function inside this subscribe function will be a function that receives a parameter. Let's call that match. And what I'm going to do is just alert whatever we get in match. So I'll just JSON stringify it and I'll just pass in match. I'll also create another function that will be executed if we run into an error. And I'll pass in the parameter and call it no match. And I'll also alert no match using json.stringify. Okay, let's save that and run our application again. So my application has run now, and now I'll close the application. And now if I click on this link, the application will open and I should get an alert in my application. And I do. And you can see all the data that I get. And here you can see that I get the JSON object. And inside this object, I have a property called $link, which is again a nested JSON object. And it contains the URL which is used to open our application. You can see that I get the complete URL. I also get a path property, which is blank as of now. I get the scheme, which is mycoolapp. I get the host, which is samarth.com. And a number of other parameters as well. We have got some information, but how can we pass in some custom parameters to this? Let's see how to do that. So what I'm going to do is just pass in a parameter called foo, and the value of this parameter is going to be bar. I'm going to save it, open my emulator, close the app, and I'm going to refresh this page to load the changes that I have made. Okay, so now I have the parameters here, and now if I click on this link, you can see that I get the parameters as well in the query string property inside my $link object, foo equals bar. Okay, basically what is happening here is every time the error callback is running. So when does the success callback run? In order to understand that, we will have to understand what are the parameters that we need to pass it in the route function. The route function basically takes a JSON object. And inside this JSON object, you can specify different URLs that your application should be able to handle. So as of now, I'm going to specify just one URL, which is going to be the root URL. And after this root URL, you can specify a value. From a component to a JSON object, this can be anything that you want. For now, I'm just going to pass in a blank JSON object here. And what happens here is that the Deep Links module matches the URL that is used to launch our application with this particular URL. So if the application is launched with this particular URL, this particular object that I have passed in along with this URL will be passed in the success callback. Okay, so in this case, if we use the root URL to launch our application, the match object will contain a blank JSON object. Let's try and run this. I'm going to save it and run the application again in the emulator. So our application has now launched. I'll close it. I'll click on the link. And this time you can see, okay, so the success callback should have been executed, but still the error callback executed. And this is because I have not specified the second slash here. Specifying the second slash here makes sure that the root URL matches with the one that we have specified in our route function. I'm gonna save it, open my browser on the emulator and reload this URL. And now I'm gonna click on this link. And this time the success callback runs. And you can see that I get a route object which contains nothing. And this is because I have specified nothing right here. This object that you specify right here will be received inside the route object. You can use it to perform any action that you want in the success callback. Another object that I've got here is the args object, which contains the arguments which were specified in our URL. So I get a JSON object with the key foo and its value bar. Along with that, I get the usual link object, which contains URL, query string, scheme, host, and other information. Okay, let's try and specify one more URL here. So I'll just type in web and its value. Let's just pass in a JSON object here. Let's call it web and let's specify its value to be true. Okay, so now our application is able to handle two kinds of URL, the ones with the root URL and the ones that have slash web at the end. Okay, so let's run this application again. So our application has now been launched on the emulator. I'll close it. I'll click on this link in the code pen. And you can see that the root URL has been matched. And this is because I get nothing in the route object. Let's close this. And I'll update the URL by specifying web endpoint. Okay. I'll save it. Refresh the page in my browser in the emulator. And when I click on this link this time, I should get an object because the web endpoint should be matched. And you can see that the route object contains web equals true passed in as a JSON object. And this is what we have specified right here. So this object right here has been provided to us in our application in the success callback using the route object. With that, I have other information like args object, which contains the arguments foo and its value bar, and the link object, which contains all the other information. So based on these objects and these values, you can decide what you want to do and where you want to navigate your user in the application. So this is how Deep Links work. You are free to try this out and let me know if you face any problems in implementing Deep Links. Also, let me know if you like this video, share it with your friends and colleagues, and give it a huge thumbs up. Thanks for watching.